the scientific argument that's occurring right now is over the effect not of the radiation that shines down on people, but on the effect of the radiation that you get inside your body. So that's what the big argument is about. Now, there's two camps here in the scientific community. The nuclear industry and the Nuclear Regulatory Commission, the Japanese government, all subscribe to the International Council on Radiation Protection, ICRP. And I call that the Bobby McFarland camp, you know, the don't worry, be happy camp. And on the other side, there's the ECRR and like-minded scientists. And the issue is what that radiation does when it gets in your body. Yes?
What's the ECRR?
European Commission on Radiological Risk. There are other groups too, but just on the opposite poles, there are some other ones. Yes, ECRR is European Commission on Radiological Risk. Yes? When you hear, you know, you get about as much radiation flying in an airplane, you know, as you're, that those issues about a millirem of external radiation falling on you, I don't think either of the parties, and it's actually a much broader spectrum, but we'll call it the oh my God, it's really bad, and the don't worry, be happy camp. Those are, between those two. They would still agree that a flight on an airplane is relatively inconsequential because it's external radiation. But the problem becomes when the particle is ingested, that's where the big scientific discrepancy begins. The, yeah, I'll take a bunch of questions later, but this gamma radiation that's shining down, we are bombarded every day by cosmic rays. And the cosmic rays we're bombarded on are about 100 millirem a year. And everybody in on the one camp will say, well, if we can withstand these gamma rays, a little cesium atom in our lungs is no big deal. So that issue of comparing an external exposure, which most scientists don't argue about, versus the internal exposure of picking up a hot particle, is the issue where scientists disagree. Okay, so now on that, here's the difference, and I'm sure there's thousands and thousands of pages written about this difference. But the difference basically is that if you get some cesium inside your body or any other isotope, what the ICRRP, the ICRP group would say is they'll take the energy emitted by that radioactive cesium and they'll average it over most of the whole organ. So if I've got a cesium particle lodged in my lung, they'll average that energy over my whole lung. Now what the other scientists feel is that that's really not fair. What's happening is that that energy is not dissipated over the whole lung. It doesn't go very far at all. But in the distance it goes, it creates much destruction. So the opposite camp is saying that the radiation does a lot of local damage. And once you've created that local damage, sometimes your body generates a cancer as a result. So the difference in the camps is, do I average that energy over the whole lung, or do I average it over a relatively small area around the particle? Now, I just had a great explanation of this explained to me just about 2 days ago, and I'm going to share it with you. The ICRP, the Bobby McFarland crowd, it thinks of a lung as, think of a stadium with 100,000 people in it. Okay, that's the whole lung. And in the middle is somebody with a high-powered rifle and 10 rounds of ammunition. Well, that person fires 10 times into the crowd. The ICRP's position is that, well, on average, that energy didn't hurt much. Now, the flip side of that argument is that the ECRR and those other scientists realize that 10 people up there, it really hurt a lot. And the other 999, whatever, the remainder of the group in the stadium, had no exposure. So that basically is the difference in the two camps. I subscribe to the camp that there's a lot of local damage caused. Not all the time does it cause cancer. A lot of times your body will isolate it or repair it, but it's more cancerous than the International Council would suggest. This is a dollar bill. This is roughly a gram. I teach physics, and if people want to, you know, we all think in pounds because we're English, but if you think in grams, a dollar bill is roughly a gram. A microgram, a millionth of this, if it's plutonium, is lethal, individually lethal. So one microgram of plutonium is a plutonium, not atom, a piece of plutonium lodged in a lung of an ape. And the tracks that you see are individual alpha particles that are shooting out and damaging parts of the lung. And this gets back to that ICRP, ECRR debate. The ICRP, the International Council, the Bobby McFarland group, would say that, well, that energy gets averaged out over the whole lung, it's not a problem. And the other camp would say, no, just look at this radiograph. And it's not getting averaged out over a large mass of that lung. In fact, it's very concentrated in a very local area.